Hello, and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Paul.
And I'm Manu.
And in this video, we will give an overview of the security architecture in Power BI. A tenant is a dedicated instance of the Azure Active Directory service that an organization receives and owns when it signs up for a Microsoft Cloud service such as Azure, Microsoft Intune, Power BI, or Office 365. Each Azure AD tenant is distinct and separate from other Azure AD tenants. A tenant houses the users in a company and the information about them, their passwords, user profile data, permissions, and so on. It also contains groups, applications, and other information pertaining to an organization and its security. The data region is based on the country you select when you create the tenant. The selection applies to sign up for both Office 365 and Power BI because this information is shared between them. Each Power BI deployment consists of two clusters, a web front-end cluster and a back-end cluster. The web front-end cluster manages the initial connection and authentication process for Power BI, using Azure Active Directory to authenticate clients and provide tokens for subsequent client connections to the Power BI service. Power BI also uses the Azure Traffic Manager to direct user traffic to the nearest data center for the authentication process and to download static content and files. Power BI uses the Azure Content Delivery Network to efficiently distribute the necessary static content and files to users based on their geographical locale. The backend cluster is how authenticated clients interact with the Power BI service. The backend cluster manages visualizations, user dashboards, datasets, reports, data storage, data connections, data refresh, and other aspects of interacting with the Power BI service. The gateway role acts as a gateway between user requests and the Power BI service. Users do not interact directly with any roles other than the gateway role or Azure API management. It's important to note that only Azure API management and gateway roles are accessible through the public internet. They provide authentication, authorization, DDoS protection, throttling, load balancing, routing, and other capabilities. In the Power BI service, data is either at rest, meaning that the data is available to a Power BI user but is not currently being used, or it's in process. For example, queries are being run, data or models are being uploaded to the Power BI service, or any other action that users or the Power BI service may take on data that is actively being accessed or updated. Data at rest in Power BI is encrypted. Data that is in transit, which means data being sent or received by the Power BI service, is also encrypted. Data and metadata for Power BI are stored in Azure Blob Storage and Azure SQL Database, and all data at rest in Power BI is fully encrypted. Datasets are made up of three parts. Metadata, which consists of tables, columns, measures, calculations, connection strings, etc., credentials, and then the data itself. All metadata for transformations, direct query, and push data are encrypted and stored in Azure Blob Storage. For credentials to the original data source, these are either stored in a Blob Storage or Azure SQL if it's a cloud source, or on-premises with the gateway. Data is stored encrypted in Azure Blob Storage or in Azure SQL for push data. And for live query and direct query connections, no data is stored. Reports are made up of metadata, static data, caches, and the original Power BI desktop file. Metadata and visual data caches are stored in Azure SQL Database. Static data is held in Blob Storage along with the Power BI desktop file temporarily after upload. For dashboards and dashboard tiles, the data needed by the visuals on the dashboards are usually cached and stored encrypted in Azure SQL Database. Other tiles, such as pinned visuals from Excel or SQL Server reporting services, are stored in Azure Blob as images and are also encrypted. Static data, such as background images and custom visuals, are stored encrypted in Azure Blob Storage. The encryption keys for Azure Blob Storage are stored encrypted in a separate location in the Power BI service. The encryption keys for Azure SQL Database's transparent data encryption technology are managed by Azure SQL itself. The encryption key for the data movement service and on-premises data gateway are either stored on-premises in the data gateway on customers' infrastructure for on-premises data sources, or in the data movement role for cloud-based data sources. The content encryption key used to encrypt the Azure Blob storage is a randomly generated 256-bit key. The algorithm that the content encryption key uses to encrypt the content is AES CBC256. The key encryption key that is used to then encrypt the content encryption key is a predefined 256-bit key. The algorithm used by key encryption key to encrypt the content encryption key is A256KW. Gateway encryption keys, which are based on the recovery key, never leave an on-premises infrastructure. Power BI cannot access the encrypted on-premises virtual credentials and cannot intercept those credentials. Web clients encrypt the credential with a public key that's associated with the specific gateway with which it's communicating. For cloud-based data sources, the data movement role encrypts encryption keys using always encrypted methods. Data is in process when it is actively being used or accessed by a user. For example, data is in process when a user accesses a dataset, revises or modifies a dashboard or report, when a refresh occurs, or other data access activities that may occur. When any of these events occur and put data in process, the data role in the Power BI service creates an in-memory analysis services database, and the dataset is loaded into that in-memory database. Whether the dataset is based on direct query or not, data loaded into the AS database is unencrypted to allow for access by the data role, and held in memory for further access until the Power BI service no longer needs the dataset. For customers with a Power BI Premium subscription, Power BI creates an in-memory analysis services database in the customer's separately provisioned collection of Power BI virtual machines. Once data is acted upon, which includes initially loading data into Power BI, the Power BI service may cache the visualization data in an unencrypted Azure SQL database, regardless of whether the dataset is based on direct query. To monitor data integrity for data in process, Power BI uses HTTPS, TCP/IP, and TLS to ensure data is encrypted and maintains integrity during the transport.
Another important question that we hear from almost all customers is, where is my data stored? When you first sign in, you can choose where your tenant is created, and your data will always reside in this region. If you already have Office 365, your Power BI tenant will be created within the same data center. If you want to see where your tenant is located, then you can click on the question mark in the top right-hand corner of the Power BI service and select About Power BI. It is important to note that all of your data will be held in this region, but not just within that data center. For resiliency, your data is held in at least two data centers within the same region. So if there were any issues with one data center, then Power BI can fail over to the other data center in the same region. All regions are within the same data sovereignty and are located in the same geography. For example, if my data was held in North Europe, which is in Ireland, then it would be backed up to West Europe, which is in Netherlands. For UK South, it will be backed up in UK West. For more information, you can go to the Microsoft Trust Center. During the preview, the audit data was stored in the US, and one of the most frequent questions we were being asked was, when will this data be stored in their data region? Gladly, now we can tell that your audit data is stored in the same region as your data. With Power BI and ExpressRoute, you can create a private network connection from your organization to Power BI, bypassing the internet to better secure your sensitive Power BI data and connections. ExpressRoute is an Azure service that lets you create private connections between Azure data centers, where your Power BI data resides, and your on-premises infrastructure, or create private connections between Azure data centers and your co-location environment. ExpressRoute also gives you built-in redundancy in every peering location for higher reliability, as well as a dedicated connection that you can dynamically scale up without loss of connection. Power BI is compliant with ExpressRoute with a few exceptions where Power BI gets or sends data over the public internet. Power BI uses multiple content delivery networks or websites to efficiently distribute the necessary static content and files to users based on their location through the public internet. These static files include product downloads such as Power BI Desktop, On-Premises Gateway, or Power BI content packs from various independent service providers. This also includes browser configuration files that are used to initiate and establish any subsequent connections with Power BI, as well as the initial secure Power BI login page. However, the actual credentials are only sent over through the express route. Telemetry data includes usage statistics and similar data which is transmitted to services that are used to monitor usage and activity. Map visuals require connection and data transmission to the Bing Virtual Earth service or the Bing geocoding service, each of which is established over the public internet. Power BI integration with Cortana requires access to Bing over the public internet as well. When custom links are added by a user, such as an image widget or a video, Power BI requests data based on the link provided by the user, which may or may not use the express route. In addition to these, users can send feedback to Power BI in text and optionally in images over the user voice feedback mechanism, which uses the public internet for transmission. The Bing News content provider downloads content from Bing using the public internet as well. When connecting to apps, for example, content packs, users are often required to enter credentials and settings using pages provided by the software as a service provider. Such pages may or may not use the express route. Express route may or may not be required in your organization. So at this point, please pause and have a discussion about why you'll need it and whether there's business justification for making this investment. Once you've had that discussion, if you do want to go ahead, then we've listed the key steps that are involved. So please note down your decision and the next steps in your strategy document. When using Power BI, you can be assured that your data is held in accordance with stringent industry safeguards. The business applications platform complies with the standards listed in this slide, and compliance is verified by third-party audits and certifications. You can also see the regions that Power BI data can be stored in. This information is subject to change and gets updated quite regularly, so please check the latest version of the Power BI Trust Center for compliance and market availability. If you're looking for guidance on how to implement Express Route with Power BI, or you want to see what services our partners can offer in this space, then please check out the marketplace. The link is in the description below. We have included a link to the slides that we've used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment below. See you in the next one.